Hello, my name is Lubin Frank Gonzalez, going to demonstrate an application on HTTP client for interacting with HTTP based APIs. Why we chose this project? Because we wanted to learn how HTTP client works under the hood, and as a web developer, it is critical for one to understand this protocol. What we're trying to build here is an application called Transporter to test web based API. Here we can do CRUD operation like get, post, put and delete, and there is also a feature for organizing request in bucket called collection. And this collection request contains various headers and data, and this is shareable, which means it can be imported and exported, making it easy to share amongst a team. And also there is an option for user to select themes. Basically there are two themes, dark theme and light theme. And this application, as you can see, is a desktop application which can be used in Windows, Mac and Linux. So let me just demonstrate how this application works. So I'll just do a get request, and this is a dog API. This API returns various dog breed list. So when I do a get request for this API, we get various dog breed list. And as you can see, this will be added to history. So if I can show you again, this is the request which we made today, and this has been added to today's date. So in history, it keep tracks of all the history data made in that particular date. So I'll just show how post request works. I'm using pass server here, and this takes some headers, and in the body we can send the data by two ways, as form data in key value pairs or a raw JSON. I'll send it using raw JSON here. And as you can see, this data has been saved in the server. So if I do a get request here, we should get the output which we have saved. So this was the data which we saved right now. We can also update it. So let me just update this score to 5432. And this has been updated. So if I do get request again for this, we should get the score as 5432. Yeah, so this works. We can also delete this object if you want to. Yeah, this has been deleted, and all this request has been added to the history data. And this history, we can clear all the history if you want to. And in the collection is a bucket which holds all these request, and we can add all these requests in a particular collection. So if I want to do show you this request collection, request for dog API, and in this, now currently this collection does not have anything, so let us add few data here. I'll do a get request, and I'll add it to doc collection, and maybe post request too. And we can see this data has been added to this collection, and this collection I can export it to my local system. This has been exported to my local system, and I get all this data along with these headers and the URL and the method. I can also import this data here. So let me just remove this, and I'll just import this. This was the one which we exported now. And yeah, this has been imported. We can also delete individual request here if you want to. And also the entire collection, also update this collection. So this is how collection works. And And about the theme, there are two themes, dark theme and light theme. This is a dark theme, and I like this theme. And this is a light theme of this application. And yeah, so that's all about this project. To speak about the technologies, we have used React and Redux. Redux is a state management tool. It is a storehouse which contains all the state of this application. And React is a front-end framework developed by Facebook. So this is a serverless application. We're not storing any data in the server. Instead, we're using local storage of the browser. If I can show you how data is stored in the browser, I'll just show you how to do that. So let me see if I have something. Okay, let me clear this. Local storage dot. So we can, this takes a key value pair. The first one is a key and this is the value of it. And this has been stored in the local storage of the world. So we can see this has been stored. We can also get back the value of it. It should be get item. And we got the value of it. So this is how you store the data in the local storage of the browser. And we have used Electron framework here. As you can see, this is a desktop application. So we are using Electron framework for building it as a desktop application. And this framework supports Windows, Mac, and Linux. And these are all the default options provided by the Electron framework. So these are the technologies. And to talk about the future work which we can do for this project, currently we have only four methods. We would like to add other method such as copy, head options, etc. We would also want to add user authentication. So like user authentication, so that we can send the collection data directly, and all this data, all the history data, collection data are stored in the cloud server of that authenticated user. And to speak about the challenges, we have, our first challenge was to learn how HTTP client works under the hood. Like, we didn't know how it works, and we had to learn like how headers are passed, how methods are passed in the fetch API. So after learning that, the other challenges which we faced was, see, these are all individual components. This is a single component and this is a single component. All this component has its own state. We were like saving the state in its own component. So what we had to do is we had to lift up the state. So we were not able to get all the data from the component. So in React, there is something called lifting up the state. So we had to lift all this data to the parent component and then do the manipulation of the data and then pass it down to the fetch API. So this was the second challenge. And yeah, that's all about this project. Thank you.